Welcome to CNS Lifestyle.
It's pizza night!
Cheers!
Hey!
So, hello. What we're going to be talking about is we're just going to give you an update on how our weight loss process has been. I'm currently doing my hair because I'm getting ready for work, so don't mind me. But I actually see a difference in my face, my arms, like
her arms.
Like literally, they used to sag all the way down here.
That's exaggeration.
No, but like, okay, maybe like right here. You see this though? It's gone down. It's still jiggly, but like it's not, like look, it stops where it used to slap the wall. So.
You're such an exaggeration.
No, but I'm telling the truth. Like, look at my arms, you guys. Look at this. Ready? And then look at this. And then bam. Oh, look at that definition. What? Look at. Oh, look at this one. Ready? Oh. Oh, look at that. See? So, Orange Theory and HotWorks has been helping a lot. I mean, I like to go to HotWorks 3 times a week and then Orange Theory 2 times a week. And that's my update for now. I really don't weigh myself as much as I used to. I used to weigh myself every single day, which I would not recommend for you guys because that's just really bad mentally, especially if you don't see the number change or if you see the number go up. And most of the time that means that you're gaining muscle rather than fat, you know?
Oh, who told you that?
So actually the nutritionist and you did.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, we were just having, not an argument, but
a tiff.
So, like most couples do, where pretty much one would say something, but if their therapist or someone else says it, it sounds so much better and it's like brand new and they magically just don't remember.
No, that's not the issue. The issue is, and it happens to Silkia too, somebody will say something and you'll be like, oh my god, like Silkia has said that before, but I've never really done it because like it didn't really make sense. But now like a professional of something is saying it and it makes me realize like Silkia was right. So like I'm not saying you're wrong, I'm saying ultimately that you're right, but I did forget because it was so long ago.
Anyways, you guys, so if you guys want to keep track of how you're doing, make sure you make a schedule. Because at least in your notes, if you have an iPhone or whatever.
This is what I recommend. The MyFitnessPal app. Everybody recommends that. The nutritionist, the gym coach recommended it. Coaches that I had in the past recommended it. I like it. Silky is not a big fan of it.
No, because I keep tabs of it mentally. Like I'm better at doing it mentally versus tracking it. Like I don't have time for that.
But see, when you but track doing it, it tracks your calories.
Yeah, but
so at your the end of the day, caloric intake is different. You want to eat less.
Yeah. So personally, even if I'm doing it because the nutritionist wants to see it. It's not for me. So that's just me. It works for her. That's great.
Just do it. It's worth it.
So just do it, you know? It might work for you. It works for most people. I don't care too much about it, but that's just me. Don't mind me. But yeah, I've seen a change in my stomach. Like, my stomach looks like it's getting smaller. What is this? This is a large shirt that feels extra baggy. Like, holy crap, right? That's pretty cool.
That is cool, since that was one of your goals, was to get a smaller shirt.
Heck yeah. My goal is to either be a very tiny medium or a small. So, yeah.
Yeah. That's so, my goals are going all right. I am trying to work out 5 times a week. This is what the coach said. There's a coach at OTF that helps me out a lot. So I try and do Orange Theory 3 times a week, HotWorks at least once, and go for a walk or something another day just to keep moving. So that's been going really well. I mean, without the coach at Orange Theory, I don't think I would be making as much progress as I'm making.
Yeah, because you'll listen to me. I tell her the same thing.
That's not true. You're not in the room, like, busting my ass.
But I'm talking about other things.
Okay, well, in the actual class, she's, like, in my face, which is helpful. Because it's more of, like, intense for me, so it's more of something I want to do, is to, like, get to that point where she doesn't have to be in my face. But I'm doing pretty good. I mean, I don't see a difference scale-wise, but I feel different. My emotions...
Your stomach's definitely gone down.
Yeah, my stomach, I guess, has gone down. I feel it a little bit, but it's still there.
I think.
My emotions have definitely been better. Like, my emotional health is definitely a lot better after the gym. So, that's a big thing for me, is emotional health. And so that's helpful. And I notice that changes when I go to the gym. Depending on which gym. I mean, after Orange Theory, I'm definitely happier. Hot Works, I'm good. I wouldn't say I'm as happy as after Orange Theory, right? But I still was in a good mood yesterday.
You're okay. I mean...
I'm okay. Thank you.
No, but I meant, like, your mood is fine after Hot Works. You're just, like, very pumped after Orange Theory.
Yeah. Well, because it's so intense. Where Hot Works is very, like, chill. It's chill, and, yeah. Like, it's those, like...
It depends on what you do. So, like, yesterday we did Hot Cycle, and I'll actually put clips of that at the end of the video of what we did yesterday, Sunday, so.
And I did Hot Cycle as well, but I also did a lot of, like, weight room stuff, which was good for me because I actually, like, worked hard. Because normally I just, like, lift and I'm like, oh, whatever. But, like, this time I lifted heavy weights. I did a lot more intense, like, workout. So, like, I was sweating. Like, I was actually doing work, which was important.
And your first time when we made the initial, like, start to our weight loss journey, you were picking up 15s. And yesterday, what did you pick up?
25s.
Yes, girl.
25s, a couple 30s, depending on what I was doing. 40s yes. For one.
And in Orange Theory, when we were doing sumo squats the other day, the coach actually pushed me too. She was like, the minimum for ladies should be 30 pounds. Well, she looked at Caitlin and I and she was like, you know, y'all need to be picking up 50. So what did we do?
Because we always go with the minimum.
Yeah. So we need to kick it up a notch.
Yep.
And there were people right next to us picking up 60, 70, 80. I'm like, my goodness.
And they were like half the size of me.
Yes.
So these girls, like, were intense.
Whew, strong. So,
yeah, we're at that point now where, like, we're getting more into that groove of what days we're working out, what days are our rest days, things like that, which I think is definitely helpful, especially for me, is trying to figure out what days are rest days. Like, yesterday, I was planning on it being a rest day, but it ended up being a really intense workout for me.
Mm-hmm.
So today, I'm taking a rest day, but come 3:45, I could decide I'm going to the gym.
Mm-hmm.
But right now it's more of a rest day. Every Saturday is a rest day for me. That's my goal, is to keep that day as a rest day. Even when I go back to work, right now I'm still furloughed, but when I go back to work, I'm still going to be putting in the same amount, even if it's 2 or 3 days in a row before work or going after work to Hot Works because they're open 24 hours.
Yeah.
Then that's what needs to happen. That's what needs to happen. But it has to keep going.
You have to keep moving. Yep.
So
I, like, today would be an Orange Theory day, but I
She's
had...
She's working at Orange Theory today.
I actually go before work, but I had a virtual session with one of my Mary Kay clients, and I do Mary Kay, so... Want to do a virtual facial? Contact me.
She also sells cookies.
I do. I bake my own cookies. It's called Silk by the Dozen. So, you know, I do a little bit of everything. So, today would have been an Orange Theory day, but after my virtual, I was like, you know what? I want to wear makeup today. So, workout or makeup? I chose makeup today. But...
I also had therapy, so normally I think if we were both going...
Yeah, we would have, like, pushed each other, like, okay, let's go.
But you know? I had therapy at the time of class, so...
Yeah, so we would have done the 11:15, but that's okay.
Sorry, Chris.
That's okay. So, yeah. That's our update so far. What we're eating is pretty good.
We're eating pretty well.
We're pretty good, actually. I keep the last two times that we made a homemade pizza, I've been wanting to actually film it, but it's just been so damn good. Like, we've been excited and just making it that we just don't record it. But I promise you, the next time that we do, we'll show you how we make it. We make it with naan bread. And it is so delicious. Very low in calories because you're making it at home. You put whatever you want on it. Obviously, do the healthy option. And, yeah. Wow, I almost burned my hair off. But anyway.
Yeah, going good. So, shout out to Aldi for all the healthy stuff.
Heck yeah. We go to Aldi for a lot of it, and it's very inexpensive. I mean, we still shop at Publix, but not as much because you can get half the price at Aldi.
Yeah. Like, I'm going to Publix today for, like, there's stuff that you can't get at Aldi
that
you have to get somewhere else.
Yeah,
like name brand stuff. Yeah. Like, our Jif peanut butter. You have to get at Publix or somewhere else, and... Publix is closest, so Publix it is, and then Aldi for the pizza stuff. Mm-hmm. We do pizza like once a week now.
Well, now we did it the last 2 weeks, but we really want to do it once every other week, but it's still very low in calories. Like, we're going to make every other Friday night a pizza night, and instead of ordering out, I mean, pizza at the Lavins, hello.
Right. Save some money.
Heck yeah, so... And it's not $20 for a box. It's like...
Yeah, I think altogether we paid like...
Like, what, $7 for... It would typically turn out to be like $5 or $7 for each pizza. Something like that.
Something like that, yeah. Because the bread's like $3 or $4.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the most expensive thing out of all of it.
Yeah.
That's it. Everything else was like $1, $2.
Mm-hmm.
Even the cheese was only like $2. So...
Yeah, so it's really not that bad, you guys. So, we'll go ahead and show you what our bodies look like. Until next time. We'll be right back.
frustrating and leaving you boredom motivates to provide the fuel to make it through this problem.
Come on,
that's
your court.
No, I might work as
well. I have a snickering.
Cheers, hot dog.